With 2023 quickly coming to a close, I met with marketing experts Randy Martinson and Chad Hart to discuss this past year and what farmers can expect to see in 2024. Randy, we'll start with you. What were some of the big takeaways you saw in the corn and soybean crop this year in 2023?
I think what was pretty impressive is that, you know, just where our yields came in, where our production came this year. You know, the way the year started off, it looked like it was going to be a tough production year for us up here, especially in the northern plains, even parts of the corn belt. But in when the time we wrapped things up, we actually turned out to have a little bit better crop than we anticipated. And it's kind of created some logistics issues moving forward here, especially now as we go to the end of the year, just what we're doing with these bushels. And it's kind of put a little bit of a wet blanket on the market.
Chad, for you, what did you see in the wheat market this year?
I think the same issue. I mean, I think when you're thinking about 2023, it was, we knew we were coming in with a drought in place. What was that going to do to us? And what we found was that the crops across the board were better than we expected at a time when, let's face it, we could have used a little bit smaller crop because demand has been weaker across the board as well.
Looking forward in 2024 in the wheat market, what are you expecting to see?
I'll give you USDA's numbers. As they're looking out there right now, they do expect to see fewer acres of wheat as we look across the landscape, likely coming out of red wheat for the most part. As we look at durum and white wheat, we're seeing a little bit tighter stocks there, hopefully holding those markets up a little better. But you're talking about a small reduction there. And the challenge of, again, trying to figure out where we're going to see demand growth as we're looking out there. Feed demand hasn't been growing much. Food demand is really stable, but it doesn't move all that often. And so typically we're looking for exports to try to help us out, and that's been a challenge.
Randy, what are you anticipating for soybean and corn coming in the next year?
You know, that's a little bit, I think, you know, kind of the same thing. We're waiting for demand to see where that's going to fall. I mean, we're looking at, you know, exports below last year's pace. You know, corn right now has potential to see some export increase, especially if we see some issues in the safrinha corn crop Brazil. But that's not going to come until after the first of the year, till, you know, January, maybe February timeframe. For soybeans right now, we do have to pay attention to what's going on with the rains or lack of rain in Brazil. That might give us some marketing opportunities ahead of the new year for soybeans. But again, it's all going to be determined on what happens with the weather in South America.
You talked about Brazil. There's obviously a lot going on outside of the United States borders right now. How do the both of you anticipate that's going to affect the markets in 2024?
You know, right now we kind of seem to be ignoring a lot of what's going on. You know, whether you look at the war in Ukraine, that really isn't bringing headlines anymore, even though Russia's trying to get the headlines by, you know, escalating their attacks on Ukraine, whether it be Kiev or their ports. And then you also have, of course, with Israel and the Middle East having that issue, you know, but it doesn't seem like the markets are being impacted much by this because it hasn't disrupted flow or production that much at this point. I think it's got potential to do it, but right now the market is being comfortable, not seeing any issues, and we're just kind of being stable because of it.
I would agree with that. The idea is, I wouldn't say we've ignored it. I would say we've gotten comfortable with it. We sort of know now how ag is going to function within the Black Sea region while the war is going on. We've seen the war between Israel and Hamas. It sort of stayed contained, and as long as it does, okay, we know what that means for us here. So the idea is that while these events are going on, they create turmoil initially. We get used to them. We figure out how to work around them. The question is, do they change? Do they escalate? And if they do, then they could have bigger impacts on the agricultural markets.
Well, it is certainly going to be interesting to see this all unfold. Thank you guys for joining me today.
Thank you.
Randy Martinson and Chad Hart. Thanks for watching Ag Week TV on YouTube. Make sure to like and subscribe. We put out new videos every Saturday.